Hey, I just uploaded a short about this, but after uploading it and watching it a couple times, I realized there's a lot more that we could talk about. So this is a medium length video that ties into my most recent video on NFL football penalties. And in this play, we are going to see a judgment call made by a referee that could have actually gone at least one of four ways, each of which would have a different effect on a game that at this point was still winnable for either team. So here's the play. Matt Ryan, quarterback for the Atlanta Falcons, takes the ball and runs the ball into the end zone for a touchdown, they say. After the play, he gets a little chirpy at number 21, Jordan Poyer, who had attempted to tackle him. So the official threw a flag for unsportsmanlike conduct, taunting. This is a 15-yard penalty that would have been assessed on the two-point conversion or the extra point try. However, upon further review, it was clear that the quarterback's knee was down, so the call on the field was reversed, no touchdown. And the unsportsmanlike conduct penalty was assessed on the next play. However, because the knee was down, there is a very good case to have called a personal foul on number 21 for what could have been seen as a late hit on a quarterback who had given himself up. So really, there are three calls here that maybe could have gone either way. Now, the touchdown was overturned, and I think most football fans would say that this was the correct call, because the rule states that if a ball carrier gives himself up, he is down wherever his body touches the ground. In this case, it's the knee. There is an argument to be made that he wasn't really giving himself up. He was diving into the end zone and his knee just happened to touch the ground. But with quarterbacks, they're almost always going to err on the side of if the knee hits the ground, the quarterback is in a defenseless position. And so in this situation, it was probably the right call to say that Matt Ryan was down. So now let's take a look at the taunting. Now, I don't know what Matt Ryan said here, but games are getting chippy all over the league. But to my knowledge, this was the only taunting call given out this entire week in the NFL. So this has to have either gone well beyond what you could call like regular trash talk, or this is a case where the referee is maybe trying to like make a statement. Maybe the referee thinks the game's getting too chippy and so he wants to maybe cool things off with a penalty that would have been on a touchdown. So it's like the touchdown's gonna stand, and 15 yards on an extra point is not a huge deal. Most kickers are gonna get that. I'm trying to think of what the official might have been thinking, and this might have been it, right? But again, without actually knowing what Matt Ryan is saying here, I personally cannot say whether I think that this is a good or a bad taunting call. It is absolutely, however, a judgment call, right? So this is the referee making this choice. And now the call that was not made that I think Matt Ryan wanted and might have been why he was chirping at Jordan Poyer, which is this late hit. Now, one way that you can look at this is it looks like Matt Ryan is going to score a touchdown and Jordan Poyer is looking to block the touchdown from happening. And his momentum has already started by the time that Matt Ryan's knee hits the ground. And you can read this as Jordan Poyer trying to kind of like roll around Matt Ryan in order to limit the contact. That's definitely one way of looking at it. You can also look at this like a late hit because, you know, it looks like Matt Ryan is going to get in the end zone regardless of what Jordan Poyer does. So Jordan Poyer diving into Matt Ryan could be seen as a late hit, right? So this is a situation where the referee or the official chose not to call a penalty that another official might have called a penalty. So this is a case where there were three calls to be looked at, and only one of these calls was automatically reviewable, the touchdown. When you take a look at the eight permutations here, even after you take away the first half, right, because the touchdown would not have stood, just those bottom four, you can see that Atlanta could have had first and goal from the half yard line, or they could have had what happened, which was third and goal from the 16, which are two extremely different things. Now, Atlanta did end up losing this game by more than a touchdown, so you could say that this particular call did not affect the game, but this game was close at this point. And if Buffalo had not scored again and Atlanta had gotten close to Buffalo's score, you could say that this actually did affect the game. I don't think any of these bottom four are wrong. I think each of the bottom four could be right depending on who the official is and how they're calling the game, right? The way that we've seen these calls go, this particular play could have ended up any of the bottom four ways and it would have been quote unquote correct. If judgment calls were reviewable, at least one of these decisions might have been reversed. It's a possibility.